Welcome to the fourth Sunday in Lent. I am not Leslie Carlson. She's not feeling well this morning, so I have taken her place. Let's open our hearts and our minds and our souls to our God. Let us worship him with thanksgiving, blessings, and praises.
May the God of hope go with us every day, filling all our lives with love and joy and peace. May the God of justice speed us on our way, bringing light and hope to every land and race. Praying, let us work for peace. Singing, share our joy with all. Working for a world that's new, faithful when we hear Christ's call.
Please join me in the responsive reading. Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to him and with songs of praise.
For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods.
In his hand are the depths of the earth and the heights of the mountains. The sea is his, for he made it, and the dry land which his hands have formed.
Oh, come. Let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker.
For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. So let us praise our Lord and God in the name of Christ our Savior. Amen.
Our first hymn this morning is For the Beauty of the Earth. Please join.
Beauty of the earth, for the glory of the skies, for the love which from our birth over and around us lies. Lord of all, to thee we raise this our hymn of grateful praise. For the joy of human love, brother, sister, parent, child, friends on earth and friends above, for all gentle thoughts and mild. Lord of all, to thee we raise this our hymn of grateful praise. For thy church that evermore lifteth holy hands above, offering up on every shore her pure sacrifice of love. Lord of all, to thee we raise this our hymn of grateful praise. For thyself, best gift divine, to the world so freely given. For that great, great love of thine, peace on earth and joy in heaven. Lord of all, to thee we raise this our hymn of grateful.
And now it's time for our missions and ministries moment. After today's service, we will be having a virtual Zoom fellowship. If you have not gotten an email from Pastor Lee, send him your email address if you'd like to join. Holy Week is coming up. March 28th is Palm Sunday. The procession into Jerusalem will be celebrated in word and music at our Sunday morning virtual service. Monday, Thursday, April 1st and 2nd, Thursday and Good Friday, we will be doing a virtual, on Zoom for that. More information to come. April 4th, Easter Sunday. This is a time where we can actually get together in our friendship circle at 8 o'clock in the morning, and we will be able to celebrate together the risen sun with communion and in-person gathering. I'd like to remind you, if you'd like to attend, please wear your mask for safety. But this will be an in-person gathering. Please join us. We are still continuing to support the church with our new roof. We, as you can see, it was quite a bit of money, and we are going to be buying a shingle to support. The money will be, if you can buy a shingle, that's probably the best way we can do something to offset the cost of the roof. And if you'd like to make a larger donation, that would be great if you can. And from the trustees, we greatly appreciate any donations that you can give. Thank you. Winter Night Walks is coming up. This is a fundraiser to provide meals. It's on April 11th. It's sign in at 12:30 p.m. The walk starts at 1. There are two distance choices. One is 2 miles. The other one will be shorter, starting at and ending at Todos Santos Plaza. See a link on our ConcordUMC.org to sponsor a walker. For more information, contact Carolyn Paulson at Missions Committee 1645@gmail.com. Small groups continue to meet virtually. For more information, we ask you to contact the person who is running or is listed for that group. Wednesday night Bible study continues every Wednesday at 6:30. We are on Zoom. Our current book is called The Call and it's about the life and times of the Apostle Paul. Our next book is coming up. It's called Simon Peter, Flawed but Devoted Disciple. We read a chapter a week, we view a video, and study a chapter 2 weeks per chapter. Each book lasts about 12 weeks. If you are interested, please contact Steve Pierce at the number below. Christ Care Men's Group continues to meet every first and third Fridays via Zoom from 10:30 to noon. Their foundations are based on getting to know each other, getting to know the Bible. They do mission outreach, concerns and prayers, and they do health, diet, and exercising. Please contact Jim McGuire if you're interested. Disciples Under Construction, led by Michelle Pope, each Sunday at 3 o'clock. Again, another meeting held on Zoom. It's a very interesting group. If you'd like to join, please contact Michelle. I'm also in that group as well. We're looking forward to getting more people. Unshakable Hope still continues to meet on Zoom as well. This is a group for people who are in their 30s and 40s. They are now meeting on Facebook Live, not Zoom, excuse me. If you'd like to join that group, you can go to the ConcordUMC.org or click on Facebook and find out more. Send us your photos. Let us know what you're doing in this pandemic while we're stuck at home. We'd like to know what you're all doing. And hopefully soon we'll be back in church, but please send your pictures to Sandy through email, and we will share them at the end of each service. Please send us your request no later than 9 o'clock on Saturday morning, so we can get them read. If you do have a prayer request and you'd like it to be read aloud on the online service, please send it to Pastor Lee by 9 a.m. on Saturday. And now it's time for our children's moment, and Betsy McLeod will be giving our children's moment this morning. Thank you, Betsy.
Good morning. I just want to say welcome to CUMC. I hope that you guys have been able to follow us while we've been on Zoom. We certainly miss you at the church, but I hope that when you come back to church, we'll have lots of you little guys because you've been participating on our Zoom church service. So I want to talk about St. Patrick's Day. I'm sure you all know about good old St. Patrick. At least you know the U.S. version of St. Patrick. We celebrate, there's many stories in connection with St. Patrick. The three-leaf clover, which actually St. Patrick supposedly used to explain the Trinity to the pagans. And also there's, you know, they thought he was driving snakes out of Ireland. That's one of the myths about St. Patrick. But actually there was no snakes in Ireland at all. So he didn't drive any snakes out. And also they said he had wars or whatever, fighting with the Druids that were pagans in Ireland. But St. Patrick himself, he was a Roman citizen, but he lived in Britain. And he was 16 years old when he was kidnapped by the pagans and taken to Ireland. And while he was in Ireland, he was enslaved. And it was really, really a big hardship on him. And he didn't like what he saw, how they treated the women and this and that. And thank God he had faith, because his faith got him through all those years of slavery and helped him become the saint that he is. And the reason he's a saint is because he went back to school and he got his, he became a priest and then he became a bishop. And he brought a whole lot of people in Ireland to Christianity. So he's the one that brought Christianity to Ireland. And the reason we celebrate him today is because a lot of immigrants came to the United States from Ireland. And so they're the ones that decided that we should wear green and we should have green beer and we should do this and we should do that. But in all reality, they do use the green symbol. And they use that in Ireland. So there's a whole lot of fun stuff to learn about St. Patrick. Not just that he, you know, the leprechaun stuff and everything, but the fact that he was a true Christian and that he really spread the word, just like Jesus did. Jesus walked among us and spread the word too, along with his disciples. So, you know, kids, that's what we need to do in our life, is we need to spread the word and we need to bring people to Christ, just like St. Patrick and a lot of other saints, like Mother Teresa, a lot of people. So if you want to be a saint, it's not that hard. You just have to be a disciple and spread the word. Anyway, God bless you all. And I hope that someday we'll be together again in person. So have a great day. Have a great St. Patty's Day. And the luck Irish to all of you. God bless.
In keeping with the theme today, the anthem is "In My Heart There Rings a Melody." This is all, again, by the CUMC Virtual Choir. We did this all from afar, and I'm really proud of everybody.
I have a song that Jesus gave me. It was sent from heaven above. There never was a sweeter melody. Tis the melody. Song with glorious endless harmony, when the chords of heaven ring.
Thank you. You are a heavenly choir. And thank you, Bill, for putting that together. I hope we get more to come. And now, look around. Is there anyone at the table with you? Is there anyone celebrating today with you? If not, we can do it virtually. We can pass the peace and we can hug ourselves and throw that hug out to the world. Because we want the world to have peace. And so we can say, may the peace of God be with you. May the peace of God be with you. May the peace of God be with you. Amen.
Today's scripture reading comes from the book of Psalms, chapter 95, verses 1 through 11. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care. Today, if only you would hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as you did at Meribah, as you did that day at Massah in the wilderness, where your ancestors tested me. They tried me, though they had seen what I did. For 40 years I was angry with that generation. I said, they are a people whose hearts go astray, and they have not known my ways. So I declared on oath in my anger, they shall never enter my rest. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Our next hymn is a canticle of praise to God. This is more of a chant than a normal hymn. And it's a little bit tricky, so if you can pick it up, please join me. Otherwise, enjoy the chant, and this is filled with much of the scripture that we've heard today.
Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and fall down and kneel before the Lord our Maker.
is our God, and we are his people. He is our shepherd, and we are his flock. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Wonderful. That's exactly how the Israelites used the psalm in their worship service. We read the psalm, but actually they sung the psalms like Bill DeGamo did it. I didn't know that Bill is 2,000 years old now. Maybe more. However, yeah, a psalm is not only a prayer that we read, it was also a music note and scores that temple choir sung, and then that's how we sing. And most of the psalms we preach and we meditate on it to learn about God and to praise God. And as you know, one third of the psalm is complaint and one third of the psalm is praise. So we know that praise and thanksgiving is a choice. We can complain or we can sing to the Lord for everything. Someone told me that she had pain on her back. Then she said, if I died in my 70s, I would not know any back pain. When I was in my 80s, I started feeling back pain. Then she said this, I give thanks to God for long life. Instead of complaining about back pain, she gave thanks to God for longevity. So she could complain about the back pain, but she chose to give thanks to God for her longevity. Another example would be someone who shared grief with me. She lost a child when the child was 2 years old. She gave thanks to God because she was able to spend 2 years with her child, having the joy of being a mother. She could cry out to God, but she decided to praise God, who shared the life of a child with her for 2 years. That was an amazing faith. I will tell you one Korean tale. There was a mother who had two sons. One son sold umbrellas, and the second son had bay salt business. When it rained, she worried about the son who had bay salt business. When it was sunny, she worried about the son who sold umbrellas. So she was always worrying about the children. However, there is somebody who had the same situations. Her friend also had two sons who happened to have the same business. However, she was already smiling. When it rained, she was happy for the son who sold umbrellas. When it was sunny, she was smiling when she thought about the son who has bay salt business. Same situation, different reaction. That's the choice. And the commandment of the Bible is this, praise God. The Psalm 95 commands us to praise God. Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to him with the songs of praise. So this is the 1 year anniversary of an online service. It's the fourth Sunday of Lent, but we have been doing this online service for a year now. So we have to make up our mind whether we want to complain or praise God. I do not know about you, but I choose to praise God. Even in this time of pandemic, we are able to have a service online because of these wonderful team, Maureen DeGamo and Bill DeGamo, DeGamo family, and all those worship leaders who participated, and all those children sermon preachers, and special guests and everybody, especially the chair of the Creative Council, Sandy Blazer. I deeply appreciate what they have done for a year. So instead of complaining that we cannot have a service in person, I want to praise God. If we decide to find the reasons to complain to God, we can find endless reasons. However, we decide to find the reasons to praise God. The Psalm 95 find the reasons to praise God. First and foremost, we praise God because God is the creator. For the Lord is a great God and a great king above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth. The heights of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, for he made it. And the dry land, which his hand have formed. We praise God because God created us. We are one of the creatures. And we praise God because God created us. And whenever we think about our parents, we love our parents, not because they are perfect, but they gave us life. We remember our roots. In the same way, we praise God with a similar reason. God is the source of life. In God's light, we see light. That's why we praise our life giver. And also, God provides. Many of us go through financial difficulties. However, we all have daily bread. Did any of you skip the meal this morning? We pray for our daily bread. And God faithfully provides. The Psalm 95 uses poetic language to show our relationship with God. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his land. Yes, that's the relationship with us and God. And I have a dog, puppy called Sammy. He eats every day dog food. Same one all the time. We don't change the brand. But he never complains. Yeah, from time to time, yeah, I give treats for special things, for trainings. However, me, I don't eat all the same food. My wife make diverse dishes for me, and still I sometimes complain. I'm spoiled, I'm a grumpy old man. So I have to learn how to appreciate more. And I'm thinking, why do we complain to God? Complaints come from desires of the world. I want this more, I want that more. We pray to God for our daily bread, and God gives us daily bread. However, after Exodus, Israelites complained about the food, manna, that God gave. Same old, same old. They think, oh, it's like a dog food, same food every day. They wanted to eat the other foods that they had in Egypt as slaves, all those garlics and other vegetables and delicious food. But remember that they ate that as slaves, and they prayed to God to be free from the slavery. The Psalm 95 says, oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Do not harden your heart as at Meribah, as on the day at Massa in the wilderness, when your ancestors tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my work. So some people would ask, what is Meribah? Meribah means test. And Massa in Hebrew means quarrel. Why they could not find water in the, when they could not find water in the wilderness, the Israelites quarreled and tested the Lord, saying, is the Lord among us or not? Are we going to die because of the thirst? And God commanded the Moses to hit the rock, and they eat water from the rock. And God said, for 40 years, I roaded that generation and said that they are a people whose heart goes astray, and they do not regard my ways. Therefore, in my anger, I swore they shall not enter my rest. When we doubt God's presence among us, we go astray. When we ask this question, is God among us or not? We do not trust God's timing and God's ways. Then we tried to figure out our own ways to solve life challenges. Then we cannot have peace and rest. A good example is in Genesis chapter 16. Let me tell you about the story. In Genesis 15:1, God said to Abram, before his name changed to Abraham, it was Abram, and God said, "Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield. Your reward shall be very great." But Abram answered with grumpy voice, "You have given me no offspring, and so a slave born in my house is to be my heir." So like God says, "Oh, I'm your shield." And Abraham says, "Oh, right, that's right. But who is going to inherit all my property?" And God said, "This man, your slave man, shall not be your heir. No one but your very own issue shall be your heir." He brought him outside. That means God brought Abram outside and said, "Look toward heaven and count the stars. If you are able to count them," then he said to him, "so shall your descendants be." So right now you have no son, but your descendants will be countless like the stars in sky. And Abram believed the Lord, and the Lord reckoned it to him as righteousness. So he started with doubt, but he had faith, and that's why we call him the ancestor of faith. However, even the ancestor of faith, Abram, in Genesis 16, took an action to have a son. You know, how weak we are, humans. We just received the promise and sign from God, but we took our own action. Sarai, Abraham's wife, before she became Sarah, she was Sarah, said to Abraham, "You see that the Lord has prevented me from bearing children. Go into my slave girl. It may be that I shall obtain children by her." So at that time, slave girl was a property of the wife. So if the slave girl has a son, the son will be the wife's son. So Abraham decided to have a son in that way. And Abraham said, "Okay, maybe I can do that. Even though I love you, maybe I really don't like her, but I love you, but I will go in." You see all those stumbling murmurings. And Abraham listened to the voice of Sarah. He went into Hagar and she conceived. She had a son. And Abraham did not have faith in God's promise. He used his own ways to get a son. Now see what happened. The Bible shows us. When she saw that she had conceived, she looked with contempt on her mistress. That means Hagar looked down on Sarai. Then Sarai said to Abraham, "May the wrong done to me be on you. I gave my slave girl to your embrace, and when she saw that she had conceived, she looked on me with contempt. May the Lord judge between you and me." Now Abraham was in trouble. Abraham did not have peace and rest now. Thank God we have only one wife, right? Between two women, Abraham had no peace and no rest. What would happen? I'm from time to time thinking about it. If Abraham trusted God's promise and waited for God's timing, there would be no Ishmael and there would be peace in the Middle East. When we stay at home longer than we expected, some people lose patience. And they said, "Let us make up our mind to wait for God's timing." And some people say, "Well, I cannot wait anymore. And I have to figure out my own ways. However, some of our church members decide to use this time for self-reflection and self-examination. They pray to God, read the Bible, and share your thoughts with others in small groups. We can go deeper and grow more. And today, Betsy McLeod shared a children's story about St. Patrick's. But I know that women's group, they are doing like Saints Madness. So they read the stories about saints. And that's how I come up with so many stories with saints. And at the men's group, we also share two stories of two saints. And they taught us a lot about patience and God's timing. And as a nation, we can also use this time for us to examine our national soul. We have to ask this seriously. Are we embracing everybody as our brothers and sisters? How can we overcome racism? Do we truly believe that everybody was created with God's image and likeness? You know, during this time of pandemic, we can examine not only ourselves, but also the soul of our nation. So during this time, decide to praise God always, personally. But also, in a group, we have to examine the character and soul of our community. And we have to pray for our nation. Lent is a time for continuous journey through hope and use every challenge and opportunity to be closer to God. Then God will be faithful to his promise in God's time. And God says, I will never fail you. I'll be with you. I will walk with you. So brothers and sisters, on this anniversary of pandemic online service, let us make up our mind to praise God, sing songs to God in the middle of all the challenges, and our faithful God will be comforting us and giving us hope for a new day. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for the patience that you planted in our heart. We grew more and more during this pandemic time. We went deeper and deeper to know the spiritual truth for our lives. Lord, we were tempted by so many worldly desires, and we are distracted by the money, fame, and riches, and all the worldly things. And we did not see you for a long time. But thank you, God, for this time of self-reflection as an individual, also as a nation. Now we calmly sit down and wait for your vision. We are distracted so many our personal desires. But now you are the master and Lord. Finally, we come to the realization that we are just creatures and you are the creator. And we are saved by the Savior. And we are sustained by the Holy Spirit. So we praise your name and bless all our church members and people who worship you with us. In the name of Jesus, our Lord, who taught us how to pray, we take a moment of silent meditation. Thank you.
Would you like to be a part of this ministry at Concord United Methodist Church? I know a lot of you already are. Thank you. If you want to help with the roof, if you want to help with the winter nights walk, there are ways to do that. If you want to contribute to the general ministry of the church, you can mail a check to Concord UMC at 1645 West Street, Concord, California. You can visit concordumc.org and click on online giving, and there are direct links there. And of course, there's always online bill pay through your bank. You can ask your bank for that information. There are ways to give. And if you can't help us financially, we want your prayers. Every week, we ask that you pray for the mission.
And now it's time for the prayers of the people. We have a couple of concerns. The first concern is the Olson-Martin family coming from Carolyn Paulson. The family lost a daughter, two in-laws, and son of a brother passed away just yesterday. All these happened in the past few months for this family, and this family really needs our prayers. From Pastor Lee, Mary Ann King fell at a shopping center and was brought to John Muir. We'd like prayers for her recovery from this bad fall. Also, her caregiver, Louise, is in John Muir Hospital after suffering a stroke. Prayers for Tom Riley, who's waiting for hip replacement, and he's in a great deal of pain and having trouble walking. That comes from Irving Lee. I know what that's like. I had my hip replaced several years back, and before I did, it was very painful. Prayers from Linda Jinks, continued prayers for her brother Peter and his wife Sue. He has finished chemo and is undergoing radiation. And continued prayers for healing for Dr. Ray Bauer and G. June's husband Nick Lackley from his thyroid. And we have some joys from Valerie Surgery. She wants to thank us for all the prayers for John's mom. She's home and is feeling much better, is breathing much better. That's the Surgery family. Prayers of thanksgiving that Contra Costa County is moving into the red tier now, finally. We're moving up a step. That's wonderful news. And we want to shout out a happy birthday today to Bill DeGarmo. Happy birthday, Bill. I believe that's it. Pastor Lee?
Let us pray together. Lord, when we heard the tragedy that Olson and Martin family has had, we become speechless and we could not find the words for comfort. So we pray to you, please comfort their heart and help them to regain strength to continue their lives. So many family members passed away within a short time of period, and we could not even imagine how heavy their hearts are. So Lord, be with them and walk with them until they finally move on to the next step. Lord, we also pray for all those people who are recovering and still struggling in hospitals. We know that Marian King and her caregiver, they both are in hospital in a very challenging situation. So we pray that you be the caregiver for both of them. And we also pray for Mr. Riley, who need hip replacement surgery, be with him. And we pray with the same passion and compassion for Linda Jing's brother, Peter, and his wife, Sue. They are going through chemo and radiation. With so many cancer patients, we know that how hard it is. And we give thanks to you for continuous recovery of Dr. Ray Bauer and Nick and Valerie Surge's mom. All those people you gave life and you are walking with them step by step every day. And Lord, we also pray for Donna Jones' friend Janice, who had breast cancer. And we pray for our sister Lee Woods, who is going through difficult times in a nursing facility. And in the middle of all these concerns, we give thanks to you because of the red stage now in Contra Costa County. We are seeing hope and the end of the tunnel. So give us more patience. Help us to be more careful not to spread this virus and keep the safety of other people as our priority. And Lord, we give thanks to you for the birthdays, especially our music team, Bill DeGamo's birthday. Bless him and make him a channel of your blessing through his music ministry and use him to spread your words in music when he sing, when he chant, when he read the Psalms or do performance. Help him to shine your glory. We pray all this in the name of Jesus, who taught us how to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Our closing hymn is God Be With You Till We Meet Again. Maureen and I love the part where it repeats during the refrain. So on the last two verses, we've added that in. And please sing it with joy.
Be with you till we meet again. Need beneath his wings securely hide you. Daily manna still provide you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet, till we meet, God be with you till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. When life's perils thick confound you, put his arms unfailing round you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet again,
till we meet
at Jesus' feet.
Till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. Keep love's banner floating o'er you. Smite death's threatening wave before you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet again.
Till we meet at Jesus' feet.
Till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet,
till we meet again.
God be with you till we meet again.
Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, who gives us hope for resurrection and eternal life, and the Creator God's love, and the sustaining power of the Holy Spirit be with us all who walk through this journey with hope, and hope of meeting again, again in person, everybody, ever and forever. Amen.